So now the skin set. It's four brushes, and I'll tell you how I came up with this. The foundation brush, that's really, really important. And it's firmer than other brushes like this, but it's softer than what most foundation brushes I had worked with, if that makes sense. So it's very, very fine. It's tapered down this way and this way, so that there's no hard lines. So when you're doing the foundation, there's not going to be all of a sudden this mark of where the brush ended and the foundation ended. So it goes on really, really smooth. But the other thing is, it's really fine this way. Why is that important? Because again, I'm very detail oriented, as well as you should be. You can go right under the lashes, right up to the edge of the eye, right directly right into, you know, different fine creases, depending on who your client is, fine lines. It is smaller than most, but in the event that you even need a smaller brush, look at this. This is the number 5. And what is it? It's a tiny little foundation brush. That's really what it is. Some people use it as eyeshadow brushes. You can use it with paints like creams and liquids and those kind of products that you use to make create a look. So if there's a little blemish, this is perfect for that. Use a little bit of whatever product you're using, and you can literally direct it and cover that exact spot, and then lightly blend that out. Maybe go over it with a large one like this, and then do a colorless translucent powder all over everything else. And you still have the luminosity of the skin. You can still see the skin, but it's the best skin that it can be. This one is kind of like that. It's just even smaller. So especially for really fine art on the face, this is great for that kind of detail. It's also good for getting right into the lash line. It's firmer than the other ones. And it's smaller. So again, even tackling the most detailed things that you would need to do, that's what this is for. Then a powder brush. It's much smaller than what is you typically find. And that is because I want powder to be only where I need for it to be. You don't have to powder a face to death. Not everywhere has to be powdered. Just needs to be powdered where shine isn't pretty. Shine isn't pretty here. You don't want to look like a mud duck, you know, like you're just a mess. So, but like, you know, these places, you don't have to completely matte down a face. And big, really big brushes, I don't know how you could do anything other than that because they're so gigantic. So the skin set are these four brushes, and I can't imagine you needing anything else.